Orthographic projection. In engineering drawing, we often have to produce 2D and 3D drawings of different parts. These 3D objects need to be shown on 2D planes, that is, X and Y planes, in such a way that we get to see all the views. That is a front view, side view, top view, etc. This type of projection system is known as an orthographic projection. In this system of projection, the views have to be drawn by following certain standard projection rules, which are known as the first angle and third angle projection methods. These methods are largely used in industries. If you want to know what the first angle and third angle projection method means, you can get the video link in the description of this video or the I button. In this video, we will learn how to draw an orthographic view from this isometric view of an object. Isometric view is a graphical method of representing a three-dimensional object. An orthographic view is a means of representing a three-dimensional view in two dimensions. It has only two axes. Let's see how we can represent this three-dimensional object in a two-dimensional view. Consider this figure. Here it is told, draw looking from the direction of X. This means we should assume the viewer is viewing the object from this direction. In other words, whatever the view from this direction will be the front view of the object in this case. Also, in the instructions, they will mention the number of views required to be drawn. If it is not mentioned, then you need to draw at least three views of the object. That is the front view, top view, and side view. Also, they will mention which projection method to use, that is, the first angle or third angle method. If it is not mentioned, then you have to draw using the first angle method. Before starting the drawing, we need to draw the reference line, which is the XY line. Since we are following the first angle method to draw the projection, on the top, the front view will come, and on the bottom, the top view will come. Next, we need to draw a vertical line, which we will name X1, Y1. The left side view of the object is drawn on the right side, as we are following the first angle method. Let's start drawing. First, we will draw the front view of the object. Since the direction of viewing is from this side, suppose you are standing here and looking at this object. This is how it will look. Only this part of the object is visible. Therefore, this is our front view of the object which we need to draw above the XY line. But to do so, we need the dimensions for this view. We can see this total length is made up of three sections of 25 millimeters, which will be equal to 75 millimeters. That means this total length is 75 millimeters, and these sections will be 25 millimeters each. Next, we need this height. We can see this height is given as 12 millimeters in the figure. This height is given as 25 millimeters. This width is given as 20 millimeters in the figure. And at last, we need this width, which is given as 20 millimeters. This is our front view of the object with all the dimensions. During exams, you can draw such rough figures, which will help you in drawing faster. Take a ruler and draw a horizontal line of 75 millimeters. Draw a vertical line of 12 millimeters and construct a rectangle. After this, we need to divide this into three parts. Take a ruler and mark 25 millimeters length and draw the horizontal lines. After this, we need to draw this section. Take a roller scale and draw a vertical line of 25 millimeters. Using this line as a reference, draw a horizontal line of 20 millimeters from here. Next, using a ruler, mark a 20 millimeters length on this line from the left edge. At last, join these points with a line. This is the required front view of the object. Next, we will draw the top view of this. When we view the object from the top, this is how it will look from the top. We can see only this part of the object. We already know this total length is 75 millimeters. Next, this length is given as 50 millimeters. This length is given as 12 millimeters. And this rectangle's width will be 20 millimeters and its height will be 25 millimeters. This distance is given as 20 millimeters. We will draw the projection lines from the front view. Take a ruler and draw the projection lines as shown. After this, we can use these reference lines to draw the top view. Take a ruler and draw a horizontal line. Next, draw a vertical line of 50 millimeters in length. We can see this length as 25 millimeters, which is equal to this length, which means the horizontal line will be up to this line. Draw a horizontal line. This height is 12 millimeters, so from here it will be 12 millimeters up. And again a 25 millimeters horizontal line, a 12 millimeters vertical line, and at last, a 25 millimeters horizontal line. Next, we need to draw this section. We know this width is 20 millimeters, which is equal to this length. This height is 25 millimeters. Using this vertical line as a reference, draw a vertical line of 25 millimeters and construct a rectangle. Also, we need to draw this additional rectangle, which represents this inclined portion. We can see this vertical line is 25 millimeters and it is 20 millimeters away from this edge, which is equal to this length. Using the vertical line as a reference, draw a vertical line of 25 millimeters in length. Next, take a ruler and extend this horizontal line up to this line. This is the required top view of the object. At last, we need to draw the left side view of the object here. When we see the object from the left side, this is how it will look. We know this length is 50 millimeters, and we can see this height is 12 millimeters. Next, this height is given as 25 millimeters, and this width is 25 millimeters. We got all the required dimensions for the side view. First, we will draw the horizontal projection lines from the front view of the object. Also, we can draw the projection lines from the top view. To do so, first, draw an inclined line which will be at 45 degrees. After this, draw the projection lines from the top view. Extend these lines up to this inclined line. And draw the vertical lines from each of these intersection points. These lines will help us in drawing the side view. Take a roller scale and draw a vertical line of 37 millimeters in length. After this, draw a horizontal line of 50 millimeters in length as shown. We need to construct this rectangle. We can see its height as 12 millimeters. Draw a vertical line of 12 millimeters and construct a rectangle. Next, we need to construct this shape. We can see the width of this shape as 25 millimeters and the height as 25 millimeters. Take a roller scale and draw a horizontal line of 25 millimeters. And draw a vertical line of 25 millimeters up to this line. At last, we need to draw this dotted lines to represent this inner section. We can see the distance of this dotted line is 12 millimeters. Mark a point at a 12 millimeters distance from this edge and draw a vertical dotted line. This is our required side view of the object. This is how we can draw an orthographic view from the isometric view. I hope this video helped you in understanding how to draw an orthographic projection of the object. If you like the video, click on the like button, and if you are new to my channel ADTW Learn, click on the subscribe button and turn on the notifications to get all my latest videos.